The Philippine public transportation sector running thin as public utility vehicle drivers are forced to quit because of high operation costs. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board says over 5,300 PUVs did not renew their franchise for the agency or have dropped out of the industry these past 2 years. That's a soaring fuel crisis, compound difficulties brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic. Taxi drivers and operators also feeling the pinch. According to Bong Suntay, the president of the Philippine National Taxi Operators Association, around 32,000 drivers have quit since the coronavirus crisis began in 2020.
Prior to the pandemic, we had in Metro Manila, we had around 27,000 units which were flying. Nung nagsimula yung pandemic and up to this time, bumaba ng 12,000 yung number ng mga units na bumabiyahe. Doon sa 12,000 na yan, you need two drivers, basically two drivers per unit on the part of the taxi. So roughly, nawalan tayo ng mga... On the part of the taxi lang in Metro Manila, around 32,000 drivers ang nawalan.
The CEO of ExxonMobil says consumers must be prepared to endure up to 5 years of turbulent oil markets. ExxonMobil's Darren Wood says this should prompt governments to think long term because the volatility will take time to end, which means crude prices may continue to rise. Meanwhile, representatives from the Middle East energy industry also renewed calls for better planning in consumer countries. Energy markets have been roiled by the Ukraine war as Russia has reduced some exports and faced sanctions.
Outgoing Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokmon remains optimistic the local economy can grow 7% this year despite global uncertainties. The incoming finance secretary admits global economic recovery prospects are again at risk due to the fallout from Russia's invasion of Ukraine, which triggered high oil prices and supply chain disruptions. But he notes the Philippine economy has a strong footing.
Maganda ekonomiya natin, ha? Kasi you have to look at the economy grew by 8.3%. There are 3 million more jobs now than before. Kumpara mo sa krisis, no? So that's March 2020. We are pleasantly surprised that the recovery came early. Kaya kami nag-adjust na kami ng interest rate. Our forecast is that yung second quarter is baka mas maganda pa siya kaysa sa first quarter.
The Philippines has revised its 2022 GDP target to 7 to 8% from the previous range of 7 to 9%. Citing external risks, unlike the Russia-Ukraine war and a slowing economy in China. A squabble between a former Philippine Bull Commissioner and the country's Youth Commission Chair intensifies as they take each other to court. Robert Manu with the details.
How do you do? Former COMELEC Commissioner Rowen Aguanzon filed before Quezon City Prosecutor's Office a cyber libel and cyber unjust vexation complaints against National Youth Commission Chairman Ronald Cardema. In her Facebook live stream, Guanzon said she is filing the complaints because of Cardema's libelous statements against her.
Sobra na itong atake ni Ronald Cardema sa akin eh. Kahit government official siya, mukhang hindi talaga siya titigil. Yung kakadakdak tsaka pabwisit sa akin eh. Puro siya defamatory remarks sa akin in public. Parang wala lang siyang... Wala siyang takot sa batas dahil akala niya malakas siya sa administrasyon. Akala niya.
Guanzon believes Cardema's personal attacks stem from her opposition to Cardema's bid to seat as representative of party's group Duterte Youth in 2019.
Yung kay Cardema, atake sa akin, personal yan. Ay, unjust vexation talaga yan. Dahil hindi siya nakaupo na representative. At asawa niya ang pinaupo namin. Bakit siya uupo? Overage siya, yun ang batas eh. Government officials kayo? Ganyan ang mga bunganga nyo.
And it's not just Cardema in the crosshairs. Guanzon is also preparing to file complaints against his wife. In the meantime, Cardema filed an urgent petition for certiorari in the Supreme Court Tuesday afternoon, seeking to block the substitution of Guanzon as first nominee of party list P3-PWD. He was accompanied by his wife, Duterte Youth Representative Duchelle Marie Cardema, and legal counsel Attorney Ferdinand Topacio.
Ang target namin dito ay ITRO yung Certificate of Nomination at kasama na rin na respondent ang House of Representatives para sila ay maging bound ng whatever judgment na ibigay po ng ating kataas-taasang hukuman.
In his petition, Cardema is asking Supreme Court to issue temporary restraining order or preliminary injunction directing the respondent COMELEC to refrain from issuing a certificate of proclamation to the substituting nominees led by Guanzon, and the House of Representatives to refrain from allowing Guanzon to assume office while the petition is pending.
Ang pinagbabasihan namin ay batas. Rules ng COMELEC, lumampas ba siya sa deadline? Yes, alam nating lahat lumampas siya sa deadline. Siya ba ay official ng COMELEC within one year after nung umalis siya? Yes, 4 months ago, COMELEC commissioner siya. May paglabag sa batas, bawal sa batas po yun, na ikaw ay makikinabang sa dati mong opisina.
Cardema also belittled the complaints lodged against him.
What is libel and unjust vexation, yung annoying to her, if you are telling the truth about her? Ito ay katotohanan, kaya nga dito tayo nagfa-file sa Supreme Court.
Guanzon believes Cardema's petition is a moot point.
Whether Cardema likes it or not, I'm going to be congresswoman.
On Friday, Guanzon is filing another complaint against Cardema in the Office of the Ombudsman for violation of Code of Ethics. Robert Mano, ABS-CBN News.